Welcome back. ABC Columbia is proud to be the home to the Academy Awards. ABC Columbia's movie critic Matt Perrone is counting down to the Oscars with reviews of the Best Picture nominees. Today's review, the Oscar-nominated film, Boyhood.
Lo and behold, day 7 of the Oscars overview is upon us. Since it's the last fictional movie day, I'm going to revisit a review I brought you 5 months ago. So, the final fictional Best Picture nominee in the one with by far the most Oscar buzz is Richard Linklater's Boyhood. Our film begins in 2002. Literally, that's when it began shooting. It follows the life of Mason Evans Jr., played by Eller Coltrane. We see him as a young boy of 6, living life as any 6-year-old boy would. He goes to school and gets into mischief. He has a sister, Samantha, with whom he has a typical sibling relationship. His mother, played by Patricia Arquette, struggles as a single mother, and we see her having to sacrifice her own time for her kids. She wants a better life for them, so they move to Houston, where she can go back to school and her mother can help with the kids. Upon arriving in Houston, we meet the kid's father, played by Ethan Hawke. He is sort of a deadbeat, trying to be a musician, but you can tell he loves his kids. From there, the movie progresses as life does, but we get to witness it and grow along with the characters. We see new relationships bloom and die. We see marriages and divorces, alcohol and abuse, and all the aspects of everyday life that make it not only hard, but an adventure all in itself. The movie becomes interesting because time progresses without warning other than the obvious aging and changing hairstyles of the characters. We see how the kids deal with different schools and homesteads. We watch as not only the characters grow, but the actors themselves. We see the ups and the downs of everyday life, and it almost feels like you are watching a documentary, even though it, in itself, is a fictional story. With the time jumps, it's also interesting because bad yet inevitable events occur, but they are just implied to have happened, rather than seeing it happen on screen. The movie lasts until present day with the one-time 6-year-old, now an 18-year-old adult, and having been with him on his entire journey, we can see how he is who he is today. Without a doubt, this film was an innovative step in the movie-making process. It's not unusual to see a character age in a movie, usually through the use of special effects or makeup. But in this film, you get to see the characters actually age over a 12-year period. Yes, I cannot stress that enough. Boyhood was shot over 12 years, and seeing the characters actually grow in age makes them so much more relatable to the audience. The year transitions can be seen not only through the physical characteristics of the cast, but through the soundtrack, as in the songs that are played match the years of the filming. I don't know how Linklater gave birth to this idea or how he sold it to the studio, but the final product is absolutely amazing. You have to admire that kind of dedication, and that in itself may actually strike Oscar gold for this film. If nothing else, it's worth seeing because it's the first of its kind. Even the 3-hour runtime goes unnoticed once you get lost in the story. Well, this has been your Oscars overview. Come back tomorrow, the end is in our sights. And if you didn't already know what I'm reviewing tomorrow, what I just said probably should give it away.
Probably should. Up next, meteorologist Jonathan Kennedy has one last look at your 7-day outlook. Stay with us for more ABC Columbia News at 12:30, live from Maine and Gervais.